from the Palace of Auburn Hills for this Eastern Conference battle featuring the Pistons here in Detroit. You're in for a treat as we bring you NBA basketball on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg with Doris Burke reporting from the sidelines. And now we take a brief check at the matchups. Our starting five for both teams. You talk about an impact player, that's Blake Griffin.
Well, everybody knows around the league that if you get in Blake Griffin's way when he has a head of steam going, you're going to end up on his poster at some point. So since coming into the league, I think he's become as intimidating a player as we've seen.
I agree. It's just not posterizing people either, Steve, although he does a bunch of that. When he gets a steal and has a free lane to the basket on a breakaway, there's a good chance the crowd's going to see a mini dunk contest from Blake.
Celtics made a special trip here for one game. Back in Boston for the next one. With most of their upcoming games taking place at home, they have a chance here to make a nice little push.
And you know, Kevin, they look like they're having fun out there, a real party. I mean, I love what I'm seeing from them in terms of their chemistry. But playing well and winning games will do it for you. That goes hand in hand. Good chemistry, wins, and fun.
Yeah, well, chicken or the egg, Clark, which comes first? I'm not sure, but they've got both right now. Great chemistry, winning games, the communication, the camaraderie, the fun, and really the effort and the passion that they're showing. It's all great stuff.
Well, I tell you, that's outstanding determination to track that rebound down and fight his way to the bucket for the throwdown.
Clark, that is the effort they're going to need for the rest of this game.
And not just on the offensive glass, Kevin, but all over the floor.
Shot clock at six. It's Williams with the drive. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
You know, size-wise, this is not a great one-on-one matchup for him, but he got that shot to go.
But you wouldn't know it by how he finished. That's a nice hoop there.
And that one falls for Williams. And now, just over a minute played here in the first. Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, Greg Popovich had a few moments to share with me. He knows that the challenge for his team in this game will be to slow down Blake Griffin, who he described as instant momentum. With Griffin being such a handful physically, they plan to limit his ability to get any space around the basket and hopefully cut down those powerful drives toward the rim.
Thank you, Doris. Griffin with the steal. Back to Arenas. Arenas missing again. Well, it was the Boston Celtics winning their last game against Cleveland.
Yeah, it didn't seem to be much of a challenge for them in that game. It seemed like they scored at will. Not much defense that they were facing.
Yep, they had the defense on its heels thoroughly the entire game, and actually nearly the entire game, and no matter what unit was out there, looked like a mismatch to me.
Now here's Arenas. After the miss from G, back to Arenas. Six to shoot. The Pistons need to get off a shot here. Ties it up. And Detroit again with the bucket. Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter. Outside Williams. Thompson outside. He dishes it to G. Lock at six. Granger from outside. No good. And it's Detroit the other way. Last game matched up with the Clippers. A tough loss there.
Well, there's no doubt they played well enough to win that game. It truly could have gone either way, Clark.
Well, the lesson in this one is you can't just play well for 3.5 quarters and expect to win. I mean, they didn't close it out the way they should have. That's on them.
Now here's Williams. 8 points his last outing. He feeds it to Elijah Wan. Just fine in the clock. They get it back. Thompson from long range. Granger.
Hard work and soft hands, guys. That's what made that play possible.
No simple offensive rebound there. Going for the tip in.
But that's the way you've got to go. If you have good position, you've got to get after it and go for that second chance opportunity.
And McAdoo kicks it over to Arenas. Shoots a fader, and they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. And the leaderboard with some point guards who have been getting their hands dirty in the paint lately. Let's take a look at the top rebounding one guards of the last 10 games. Well, you look at Williams, third in rebounding, and what a physical presence inside.
And it may not be the first thing you think about, but if you look at a lot of the all-time great point guards, rebounding was always a big part of their game.
Yeah, I think that's true, Steve. It's not a necessary attribute for a point guard, but the ability to rebound is something that took a few of the greats to another level entirely, and it helps your team, too.
The Celtics shooting their second and third free throws tonight.
And they've shot the ball well all season long from the free throw line, about 81%.
And guys, that's really an upgrade over how they shot last season. Not a huge upgrade, but an upgrade nonetheless.
Slimmy's checked in for the Pistons. That one misses. Detroit's gone 0-2 from deep here. And the pass to Arenas. That one's good from the corner. Arenas has got his first 2 points. Boston trailing. First chance of the season for them to go up against this Pistons team.
Yeah, they dropped the season series to this team a year ago. So those games definitely were not their best performances of the year.
Passes to Elijah Wan. Thompson outside. Six on the shot clock. Boston, no good that time either. And as Steve just alluded to, this wasn't an opponent that too many teams had trouble with last season. They were one of the few that did.
Well, they seemed to have a hard time getting up for those games, guys. I mean, they were an example of how sometimes you can indeed play down to your opponent, or your opponent plays up to you.
This quarter has not been his best. The defense may be starting to affect him a little bit.
G dishes to Williams. He kicks to Thompson. The feed to G. Pass to Granger. Another miss by Granger.
What was the defense doing there? I mean, he is not the guy to give an open look to, and yet they got away with it. Some rugged defense there against one of the stronger finishers in the game.
Thompson outside. Outside Williams. Back to Thompson. Thompson off the pick from Elijah Wan. Granger from outside. Gets it to go. Granger's got 5 now.
And these two teams continuing to trade blows like heavyweights in the middle of the ring.
So many times tonight, the energy in this building has gone from one way to the other.
Now here's Arenas. He's coming off a 40-point game against the Clippers.
And he really kept his head down with drawing contact, getting himself to the line. Played an aggressive game. That was a big-time help for him and his team.
So the Celtics called timeout. They're first.
He has to be concerned with all the missed shots. I mean, it happens to every team, but you have to find a way to keep him productive even when you go through a shooting drought.
He might be trying to tell them to get to the free throw line. You know, all teams go cold at points during the game, but the good teams still find ways to score.
The Celtics making a switch here. Weber's checked in. Here's Williams, averaging 9 points per contest. The dish to Thompson. He passes to Weber. Back to Thompson. Down to 5 on the shot clock. A jump hook gets it to go.
Offensively, he can be the engine that drives them at any given time.
Left side Arenas. And out of bounds as the Celtics gain possession. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out east already. We are in December. Taking a look at Boston. So far, they've got the 4th best record in the conference. And, of course, there's the Pistons. Not really any threat right now as their record showing a lot more losses.
You know, right now for the Celtics, they've been holding their own to start the season. This is a team that is worthy of keeping an eye on. A solid start, and they could maintain this momentum for a while.
Well, we know they're a playoff contender. playoffs, you know, that's something that was easily predictable. The question is, what steps can they take to improve a little bit more to get to the point where they can become a true championship contender?
Their whole defense is better just with him being out there, Kevin. His ability to know exactly what's going on, to communicate, to be in the right position. And he's a great example for his teammates to follow.
And I'll tell you one more thing about him, Steve. He sets a screen maybe better than anybody. And if he rolls off of it, he gets the ball and gets a clean look. It's automatic.
Brown is checked in for the Pistons. No good on the second, so he hits one of two. Pistons trail by three. Brown with a screen on Granger. Here's Arias, and he gets the shot to fall after coming off the pick.
Great job of utilizing that screen and finding space to knock down the jumper. Good basketball.
And Williams, here we go. Now Elijah on inside. Gilbert Arenas with the rebound. The Pistons have gotten 6 of 11 shots to go down so far. Pretty nice shooting. Number 45. A three-pointer off the mark. Boston's gone. Just 1 of 4 from three-point range here in the first. Dishes it to Granger. Kicks to Thompson. Lets it go. Out of bounds. Detroit takes possession.
Here's where Boston sits right now, Kevin, in the current league rankings. Second in fewest turnovers per game. Fourth in blocks. And they are in the top 10 in field goal percentage. This is a team that shows excellent discipline at the offensive end.
And Clark, you know, when you commit so few turnovers, it's key because you become a much better offensive team. You're constantly getting looks at the basket, and your defense isn't vulnerable either because you're able to get back in transition so much easier.
And Griffin backs in. 11 feet away, and Boston with the rebound. It's Thompson off the drive. It's stolen by Brown. Lays out. It's stolen by Olajuwon. And pushing it up, here's Boston. Danny Granger, the bucket on the assist by Olajuwon. 7 points for Danny Granger.
Not trying to rattle any rims or racks there. Just up and in with the finger roll.
Williams against Arenas. Back to Brown. Just 5 to shoot. Granger with the defensive effort. Celtics leading by 3. Out to Thompson. Boom, he jams it straight down.
Now that is a quick bucket. Pretty good in transition.
That's right. That's exactly right. He loves when he gets the chance to get out and run. That's when he's at his best.
And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Celtics.
And right from the start, guys, it's apparent they're determined to establish a presence in the paint.
They've been distributing the ball really well tonight, too. I mean, a decent number of assists so far for them.
Detroit's gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. There's the pick. On the wing, Brown. Detroit, no good that time either. The Celtics have gotten 7 of their first 16 field goal attempts to go down here in the first.
And their lead takes another little bump up.
Boy, I tell you, they've got to be feeling better and better about this game.
The Celtics shooting their 7th attempt at the foul line in this one. Tony, he's checked in for Thompson. And the free throw, no good. Pistons trail by 8. Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cottonmouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Sampson, the pass to Brown. Lock at 6. There's the pass to Sampson. And they get it. And that one's good. Slim's got his 2nd bucket of the game to go. Celtics leading by 6. 1:52 left to play here in the first. Back to Tony. Celtics passing it around. 6 to shoot. And the Naturals going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line. The Celtics have missed more than they've made at the foul line tonight. 3 of 7. free throw good from Weber.
And you can see in this game how aggressive they've been. I mean, that's created a lot of opportunities at the line for him.
He doesn't get the second one, and they've made the most of their opportunities.
Yeah, you're right, Kevin. They opened up a good lead as a result of being able to get to the foul line and knock down free throws.
That one goes. Come. The Celtics with the lead. 1:19 left to play in the first. Gets it to go.
They've got to continue to put pressure on the defense by probing inside. That's what's really working for them.
And when you're doing the job they are inside, it takes pressure off the perimeter guys.
Here's Money. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Offensive rebound. Sampson. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Now that we have a moment, let's take a peek at the teams that are leading the league in blocks.
In fourth, the Celtics.
And I think a lot of it has to do with their defensive schemes, guys, because they rotate beautifully, and somebody is always there to protect the basket.
The first one falls. All free throws good from Sampson. There's 57 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Tony kicks to Weber. Back to Tony with the lead pass. It's stolen by Brown. Here's the natural. Rejected by Tony. Feeds it to T. Back to Tony. Goes back up. The shot's good from McDaniel. And the Celtics lead by 7.
You got to put bodies on the glass right there. They just are not getting it done on the boards.
Yeah, they've got to do a much better job of going harder than that to the glass.
About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. It's Brown on the wing. 5 on the clock. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here. It's his first trip to the line.
Well, you got to admire what he's been able to do at the free throw line this season, shooting better than 90% from the stripe.
You know, one thing about getting going at the free throw line like he has this season, it can continue to carry over.
The first free throw is good, and the Pistons making a change here. And he makes both free throws. Now T. And another basket for Boston. And so the first quarter is in the books. Celtics lead by 7. And we'll be back in just a moment with the start of the second quarter.
December 20th, the Sacramento Kings go up against the Toronto Raptors. Don't miss out.
And now the second quarter just getting set to start. What do you guys think about the Celtics here in this one?
Really good sign offensively the way they started this game out, getting a lot of hoops from close range.
Yeah, it's a lot easier to get baskets inside. I know you were a three-point shooter, Steve, and a really good one, but it's always easier to score in the paint.
Pistons trail by 7, and now brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. On the court for the Celtics, we've got Weber, Teague out there with Tony, and it's McDaniel at the three spot. Shot clock at 6. Pass to Money. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2. And here's what the Detroit Pistons schedule looks like. When this game is done, they'll be off to Chicago as they take on the Bulls. That's game 1 of a 3-game road trip. First trip to the line for him here.
Easy point. Come on.
That free throw good for money. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Boston leading by five. Tony kicks to T. Back to Tony. Pass to Weber. Again, the Celtics good for two.
Looked like the defense kind of backed off him, and he took advantage.
The Pistons shooting the ball at 42%. Number 25. Here's the natural. Good D by Weber.
Great job defending the hoop there.
So important to have good presence defensively inside.
Here's Teague. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
I think they need to get much more disruptive defensively. They can't just keep allowing these easy baskets.
I agree. They need more energy in the post, maybe some double teaming. They've got to get their defense in gear.
G's checked in for Boston. Just over 1 minute has passed here in the second quarter. And the Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here.
Well, they're getting way too many easy shots in the paint. So this timeout is specifically for that reason. You got to tighten up the defense and start to make it harder for that offensive team.
I know it's easier said than done, but right now it just doesn't seem like the necessary effort is there.
Money passes to Brown. Nice ball movement by Detroit. Pass to Money. Five to shoot. The three. And again, it's the Pistons missing. Celtics leading by 10. Can't connect from short range. And here comes Brown, leading the fast break. He muscles it in through the contact, and they call the foul. And he's on his way to the free throw line.
Defender a little hesitant to offer resistance as he bursts to the hoop.
One shot. Pistons have made all of their free throws so far tonight, going 6 for 6.
And they've shot the ball well all season long from the free throw line, about 81%.
And, you know, I really think the hard work they've put in the offseason and so far this year really making a big difference. I mean, they've made a huge improvement in their shooting at the line.
Teague, the pass to McDaniel. Back to Teague. Beyond the arc. It's rebounded by the Natural. The Natural's got 4 rebounds now tonight. And out of bounds as the Celtics gain possession.
You can see where the Pistons rank in the league stats over these last 10 games now. Third in steals, 10th in assists, and they're in the top half of the league in blocks. That's pretty good. Not too bad.
Yeah, let's go back to those steals for a second, Clark. I think that's such a key aspect for this team's success, because when they get out and really pressure teams and force mistakes, that allows them to get easy shots at the other end offensively.
Celtics have made 5 of 10 free throw attempts, a lot of misses. Free throw, good team. Walker's checked in for the Natural. And so T gets 2 free throws.
Shooting 100% in the quarter. They've made them all, taking full advantage at the line.
Well, it's a nice job of really making the most of their opportunities.
Money passes to Walker. The Cobra. He passes to Money. And it's Walker penetrating. Rebound Boston. Weber's got his 3rd rebound tonight. T kicks to Tony. The pass to McDaniel. To the middle. Got a piece of it. And stolen by McAdoo. 3-on-3. Passes it to Money. Blocked. Puts up the baby hook. And it's Weber getting it to go. Weber's got 6.
Their prowess inside has been tremendous, guys. I mean, it's been no contest down on the low block.
And until they prove they can stop them, I mean, they ought to continue to pound it in low.
Well, he just didn't make the catch, didn't look the ball into his hands. He must have thought the ball was going somewhere else.
And the Pistons making a change here. And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. Outside Teague. Pass to McDaniel. Back to Teague. He dishes it to Tony. Shot clock at 5. To the inside. And Weber with the basket on the assist from Tony. 8 points for the Beast.
Good ball movement. He put that pass in the ideal spot, right where it needed to be.
Number 45, defended by Tony. And that one's good. And that's now 6 points for the Cobra.
Easy little jump shot for him right there, guys.
Time call here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. Now, most coaches will tell you, you need scoring in the paint to be successful. Here are some big men around the league that have been providing plenty of that over the last month. And you look at the Cobra, among the league leaders, fourth in scoring.
And there are different styles among those big men, but they have one thing very much in common. They can dominate offensively, face up or back to the basket. They can get it done.
And that's what makes that list so intriguing to me, Steve, just how varied it is in terms of technique each of those big men use. I mean, you could fill a textbook by taking a little piece of each of their games. I mean, they all do something different and unique and do it well. Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Now, you got to make a defensive adjustment here, Clark. Time to collapse inside, force the ball back out in the perimeter, make them beat you from long range.
And it's out of bounds to the Pistons as Detroit retains possession. Outside Arenas. Pistons keep it alive. McAdoo. Nice D from Tony.
Boy, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Here's G. And he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down. Well, now they're just going to town on him.
Yeah, you'd think these defenders would have done a little more to put a stop to that stuff, Kevin, but so far, no go.
Well, a phenomenal aerial assault there, fellas.
Outside Arenas, the Cobra. That's good, and it's Arenas with the assist. Arenas has got 3 assists now in this one.
He had his head on the swivel and was able to pick out the pass and get the assist.
Tony dishes to Teague. McDaniel, the pass to Teague. The Celtics working the ball around now. 5 on the clock. Sinks the triple. Teague's got 10.
No, it looks like he's finally found his footing in this game. His first quarter was a real struggle, but he's gotten it going now.
And Walker kicks it over to Arenas. Outside, Walker. Number 45. Pistons keep it alive. So the whistle blows on the shot and 2 free throws for the contact right there. For Detroit, they have gone a perfect 7 of 7 from the line tonight.
You got it, baby, yeah!
First one falls for.
Hitting your free throws is a good way to get back into it. It stops the clock and extends the game. I mean, you want to take advantage of that situation. And they're shooting much better from the line here in the second quarter. So far, they haven't missed one.
And both free throws good for Arenas. Austin with the ball. Atlanta will be traveling to face them after this game. That'll be the first of 2 straight at home.
You know, that Atlanta game has a lot of attention on it.
Out to Thompson. Outside Williams. He feeds it to Granger. A 3 ball. That is good. Granger's got 10 points.
it's obvious he's hurting. I mean, he's going to tough it out, though, and continue to contribute. You got to give him credit for that.
Griffin, a screen on Thompson. Arenas passes to Walker. Back to Arenas. That's good. He's got eight.
How many times have we seen him do that? Just batter a defense with his ability to explode to the basket.
Williams a screen. Granger kicks to Thompson. Williams dishes to Elijah Wan. Now the feed to Granger. And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back. And this is what the schedule looks like for the Boston Celtics. Atlanta will be traveling to face them after this game. That game marks the first half of a quick two-game homestand. Our timeout called by Detroit.
Coach can't be pleased with their inconsistency on the defensive glass. They've been caught taking pictures out there. They're watching, as opposed to getting in there and securing the orange.
Pistons trailed by 15. Arenas is doubled. They get a hand on it. Taken away by Williams. Thompson. He misses the wide open dunk. And now the Pistons fast break. Up the floor. Hit them clean. McDaniel the pass to Williams. He kicks it to Granger. Granger gets a screen from McDaniel. Granger misses.
Well, with that much space off the pick, you've got to drop that in.
Yeah, you got to make that one. I mean, that's a high-quality shot you should make 9 out of 10 times. And, guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defender with the way they work down low.
Well, it's become one of the stories of the first half, but just piling up points in the paint.
But three, the shot's good. Granger's got 6 points in the quarter.
And what I like about him, he needs very little time to get his shot off. If he has just a bit of room, that's all it takes. In a catch-and-shoot situation, he's going to let it fly.
And, Steve, very few players have his finishing ability. We see him get a lot of and-ones because even if he draws hard contact, he is able to play through that and typically score. Boy, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition.
Pistons trailed by 19. Now the dish to Walker. Griffin sets the screen for Walker. Griffin a screen on Granger. And Walker kicks to Griffin. Three-pointer. Arenas can't hit.
You know, he just hasn't looked right to me. A bit out of sorts, if you will. Something's off with his mechanics, at least as I look at it.
Outside Williams. Six to shoot. Fades back, and they force the shot clock violation. Great D.
And let's take a look now at Gilbert Arenas' numbers. Some good stat lines for him recently. You can put his numbers up among the best lately. Third in steals, and of course, passing, such a big part of his game, one of the top 15 leading assist men in the NBA.
I think, Steve, there's an awful lot to be said about his top three ranking in steals average. I mean, he really thrives on playing defense, and you should when your hands are as quick as his. I mean, that's something you want to use to the benefit of your team.
Pistons have been exceptional shooting free throws tonight, going 9 for 9. Here's Williams. 6 points for him. Dishes to Thompson. Thompson off the pick from McDaniel. It's Thompson off the drive. He got right to the cup using that screen. Thompson's got 9 points. Pistons trail by 18. outside Arenas. Kicks it to Walker. Back to Arenas. The shot's good on the assist by Walker. And that's now 11 points for Gilbert Arenas.
It's his first three-pointer of the second half, which actually makes it his first of the game.
And Thompson kicks to Williams. Back to Thompson. Feeds it to Williams. Nice ball movement by Boston. Out of bounds, Detroit takes possession. Terrific awareness among this collection of centers and power forwards. The big men averaging the most assists per contest over the previous 10 games. Fourth, Blake Griffin.
Well, it takes tremendous feel for the game to be able to make the passes these big guys are capable of making out of that low post area.
Absolutely, Steve. I mean, these fellas play in the high traffic area on the court, so the passing lanes for them are a lot tighter than they are out on the perimeter. Not nearly as much room.
Back to Arenas. Down to five on the shot clock. And the slam by Blake Griffin.
Really hard to decide, guys, which was better, the pass, the catch, or the slam.
Hart, there's no wrong answer to that one, my friend. Sensational alley-oop all the way around.
Agreed. All of the above. Yeah, and guys, it's his consistent shooting that's really helped get his team into a position they're in right now.
Knocks it loose. And now Williams running the floor all by himself.
Guys, that's simply superb. Ball pressure, a run out, and then a dunk in transition.
Exactly, Clark, what they wanted, the aggressive defense to lead to.
Yeah, points in transition.
That's why you want to make the other team feel uncomfortable handling the ball, because you can get easy points out of it at the other end.
Pass to Walker. Soft touch off the glass. Walker's got his first points of the game.
Great interplay there between those two teammates.
Outside Williams. Olajuwon with a screen on Arenas. Thompson outside. Olajuwon defended by McAdoo. Second chance shot. And so that's the end of the first half. Boston on top, up by 15. And coming up after the break, it'll be Damon Bruce breaking down all the highlights from the first half of play.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
Let's get into the first half breakdown. We're starting to get into the thick of the NBA season. Boston leading against the Pistons at the Palace of Auburn Hills. They've been having their way inside, a huge lead when it comes to points in the paint, making it very hard to defend against them. Danny Granger's just having his way against this Piston D. He's got 13 points, and it's been bombs away from outside. The Pistons on the other side, not firing. Their outside scoring is letting them down so far, and without that threat from outside, their offense is bogging down, unable to spread the floor. Gilbert Arenas making a big contribution. He has 11 points. He's been getting it done on both ends of the court. Look at the assists. Look at the rebounds. It's all adding up to a great first half. Now let's take off with some other games in progress around the league. Dallas battling in a close one against Indiana. Second half of play, still anybody's game. And another game going on out in Brooklyn. It's the Nets trailing to Miami. Second half of basketball just getting started for them. And a look here at the other NBA action. It'll be the 76ers against the Hawks out in Atlanta. That one gets started at 8 Eastern. And that's all there is to it. Thanks so much for spending halftime with me. Now it's time to send you back out to the start of the third quarter.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And as we welcome you back, we begin our second half. So far, not a tightly contested game, guys, but, you know, anything can happen. An exceptional performance from Danny Granger.
Well, he created a lot of opportunities for himself in the first couple of quarters. And I'll tell you what, he was smart with his shot making, too. Really took good ones.
You know, points per shot attempted is really one of the undervalued stats in the game, and it's a real measurement of efficient scoring.
Thunder is out there with Griffin. Then it's Gilbert Arenas. Then it's the Cobra. That's the group for Detroit right now. Williams kicks to Thompson. And he sinks the shot coming off the strong pick. Thompson's got it going here in the start of the second half. The first points in the third quarter for the Celtics. Williams against Arenas. And there's the pass to Mackin. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. This is his second trip to the free throw line. And he knocks down the first one. And so he makes both from the line.
Well done again. He doesn't have the same problems at the line that plague some of the NBA's other big men.
Granger outside. Back to Williams. Thompson dishes to Williams. Passes it to Thompson. He feeds it to Williams. A floater. The shot misses. And Detroit the other way now. Arenas with it. And Granger picks him up defensively. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Gilbert Arenas. That'll be his second foul of the game.
What a great play to sacrifice his body and take the hit.
Yeah, I thought that was excellent awareness and anticipation to beat him to the spot there.
Outside Williams. Granger passes to Williams. Williams gets a screen from Elijah Wan. And it's Granger penetrating. Kept alive. Gee. And he uses the glass on the layup. Gee's got his second basket of the night.
That rebound and the follow kind of typify what he's all about. Just gritty, determined play.
And that's out of bounds. Detroit will retain possession.
That was an awfully risky pass, guys. Lucky it didn't wind up as a steal.
Well, it nearly did wind up as a steal, but no harm done in the end. They hang on to possession.
Here's McAdoo. That falls. Nice feed that time from Walker. 17 points for the Cobra.
They ran that inbounds play perfectly there to get the quick hitter.
Outside Williams, pass to Granger. Got a piece of it. Stolen by Walker. And now the Pistons, fast break. Walker leading the charge. Celtics leading by 15. Here's Williams. Sinks it from just inside the baseline. Williams has got 10 points.
Boy, they've looked good in the open floor today. That's had a lot to do with their success.
Well, they've been doing the right thing, Steve. Anytime they've had numbers, they've gone straight up court with it right away. Boom.
He dishes it to Arenas. He passes to McAdoo. Back to Arenas. Six on the shot clock. Tipped away. And now Williams running the floor all by himself. The feed to Griffin. Walker. The shot by Arenas. And that one goes long.
Such a solid performance for them inside. Their rebounding has been terrific.
Yeah, that's just one of the few things that have gone their way today.
Thompson with the bucket.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Yeah, that's five of their last six baskets inside the lane. They have really established themselves inside.
Griffin sets the screen for Walker. Nice job coming off that screen.
The screen play worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screen play you see in a movie theater. Gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
The last few weeks, you see how Boston stacks up. Third in blocks, third in fewest turnovers per game. And they're in the top half of the league in team rebounding as well. They've got some glass eaters on that squad.
And to me, what really stands out with all those numbers you talked about, Clark, are the blocks, because they're a physical team. They're dominant in the paint, and they've got great length. And when they're between you and the basket, it's tough to get a shot over these guys.
Hit his foot, and it's whistled a kick. He kicks it to Thompson. The dish now to Olajuwon. Griffin on him. Baseline try. That's good. And the Celtics lead by 19.
Tough assignment for that defender with the size mismatch we're seeing.
Yeah, I just don't think he's big enough to handle it.
Arenas missing again. Boston's gotten fewer than half of their three-pointers to go down tonight. They're 4 for 9. Williams. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line. And a closer look here at the hustle stats for Boston.
Forcing turnovers. You want to convert at the other end. That's what this club has done.
They've repeatedly gotten out on the break tonight as well and scored a lot of baskets in transition.
That one misses for Williams. Pistons trailed by 21. Number 45. That's good. The Celtics have gone 6-9 from the floor here in the second half. They've got to be happy with that. There's the lob to the hoop, and Thompson throws it down.
Boy, the prettiest play in basketball to me. Execute it to perfection.
I don't think you're going to get an argument there. Everybody loves the alley-oop.
Well, unless you're the team getting dunked on, of course.
Dishes it to Arenas. Clock at 6. Kicks it to Walker. And Granger with the block. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. And now a look at the 2K leaderboard to see which point guards have been playing the best perimeter defense during the last month. In third spot, Gilbert Arenas.
And not only are these players tremendous at picking ball handlers' pockets, but as terrific point guards, they know how to clog passing lanes and come up with a lot of steals that way as well.
Absolutely. Their steals come from all over the court and in all sorts of situations. Transition, half-court sets, out-of-bounds plays, in the lane. They are the NBA's most complete defenders at the one-guard spot.
Williams kicks to Granger. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist. 16 points for Danny Granger.
They've done a lot of good work with the ball, really moving the ball and moving bodies, getting quality chances at the hoop.
And they're not wasting chances when they get them. They're hitting their shots.
So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
First personal foul, number 45. Shooting free throws.
And the first one drops. The Pistons making a change here. McAdoo's checked in. And good on the second, so he makes them both.
100% free throw shooting this half, guys.
Efficiency is so crucial when you're trying to overcome a deficit, Steve.
Back to Williams. Granger outside. Williams a screen on Arenas. Here is Williams. 12 points for him. Here's Granger. And another basket for Boston. The Pistons have gone 3-7 on field goal attempts here in the second half. Outside Arenas. Pass to McAdoo. Back to Arenas. Just 5 on the clock. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Arenas has got 13 points. Outside Williams. Back to Olajuwon. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Gilbert Arenas. That's his 5th foul.
Boy, it's been a tough go in terms of fouls for him. I mean, my goodness, he can't stay out of the way of fouls.
Blake Griffin, he's checked in for Walker. Olajuwon dishes to Granger. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. It's going to be on Blake Griffin.
Well, we're seeing the Pistons unable to defend against Granger.
He has 18 points, and he's drained 4 3-pointers here as well.
With more to come, maybe. The way his shot looks tonight, it looks like he's in for a big night.
That's good from Granger. Granger hits them both. Here's Arenas. 13 points in the game. Griffin a screen on Thompson. Back to Arenas. 6 on the shot clock. Inside. And it's out of bounds to the Pistons as Detroit retains possession.
4 seconds on the shot clock.
Clock at 4. And the rebound goes to Danny Granger.
Well, it's the edge they've had in that area on the glass that's played a big role in this game.
Yeah, they've got some strong guys, Steve. Guys that are strong and well put together, and they've used that strength to their advantage down low.
Outside Arenas. Tries again. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
That's his first personal foul. Third, Blake Griffin. Shooting free throws.
First free throw is good. He's checked in for Boston. And so he hits both. Williams with the ball. 12 points for him. Thompson outside. Back to Williams. The Celtics working the ball around now. Feeds to Thompson. 6 to shoot. Number 13. And fouled as he went up to the dunk. Good aggressive move, and he'll shoot 2.
Yeah, nice body control there. Narrowly missing the shot. Would have been a 3-point play.
Had a free look at it after the foul. Nice play.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
This is a positive trend for him, especially here in the second half, shooting just above 80% right now. That's more than respectable. That's good free throw shooting.
Outside Arenas. Number 45. And shot opportunity. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Pistons will retain possession. The lead pass, and the best is good. 6 points now in the game for Walker.
One of the reasons they're behind is because we haven't seen enough of that. He needs to become a bigger part of the offense.
The putback controls the rebound and puts it back up and in. 22 points for Danny Granger.
It's a +5 advantage for them in the rebounding category after that board.
Very steady work they've been doing on the interior, no question, and that's, I think, the main reason they have this lead.
And that one's good. Arenas has got 4 points in the quarter.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Yeah, absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding. They are piling up the assists.
Granger kicks to Williams. Now the pass to Thompson. And it comes off the front of the rim. The Pistons have gone 6 of 14 since halftime. A little cold from the field. On the corner. Again, the Pistons good for 2. Celtics leading by 20. Back to Williams. Granger right side. Knocked loose. And now the Pistons fast break. Arenas with the ball.
Well, the number one priority for defense when you face this guy is to keep him getting anywhere from the basket because he's too just so strong as a finisher.
And something else he has is an array of moves in the paint. You can make a training video for young players to figure out how to play down low in terms of how he gets it done inside.
Just find the shoot. Here's Thompson. Rebound, Detroit.
That's not an opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Passes it to Arenas. Another three for Detroit.
This guy will really make you pay if you leave him enough room outside.
Boston's gone 5-10 from downtown tonight. 50% exactly. On the wing, Granger. Latrae. And yes, sir, that one drops. Granger's got 12 points here in the second half.
He has really put his foot on the pedal this quarter, doing a tremendous job leading their offense.
Arenas off a pick from Walker. Back to Arenas. And that shot misses everything. Air ball on the three. Granger outside. The dish to G. He feeds it to Williams. Blanketed by the D, he fights to the rim for the layup. Williams has got six in the quarter.
I like the way he's not forcing anything, taking advantage of what the defense has given him. He's been a key contributor for them in this quarter.
Arenas kicks to Walker. From the high post, and the Pistons getting another bucket right there.
You know, he's knocking down his shots today, but it hasn't really translated to the scoreboard yet.
They set the pick. On the wing, Granger. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist. Williams has got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Arenas passes to Walker. Number 45. He's covered by Thompson. And Danny Granger gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. Outside, Arenas. Pass to McAfee. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. It's going to be on Hakeem Olajuwon. And he can't get the first one. And the Celtics making a change here. He hits the second from the line. 9 seconds left to play here in the third. Fades and shoots. Oh, and the buzzer beater's good.
Pretty shot without a second to spare.
This Thursday night.
And thanks again for joining us. Let's see what happens here in the fourth. Boston leading by 21. And a look at the five for the Celtics to start the fourth quarter. Rubber is out there with Olajuwon. Then there's Tony. Then there's Teague. And it's Granger in at the small four. Weber can't hit. And, well, Detroit shooting 48% from the field. Not bad at all. He dishes it to Brown. Shot clock at six. Ball's knocked loose. Stolen by Granger. The finish. Hammers it in after taking it the length of the floor.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
It feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
The feed now to Arenas. From deep. But they recover it. Rejected by Weber. And the whistle blew, so that'll be a shooting foul. Great defensive effort there with the blocked shot. But he got more than just the ball that time. Free throws coming up right now. And he makes the first. The Celtics making a switch here. Thompson's checked in. So he makes one of two as the second one misses. Celtics leading by 22. On the wing, Granger. The feather touch on the finger roll. Beautiful. Granger's got 4 points now in the quarter.
What a top-notch game he's having. He's gotten them in front, and it sure seemed like he's going to keep them there. All by himself, it looks like.
There's the pick. Number 25. He's covered by Thompson. Here's Arenas. Pistons keep it alive.
Multiple possessions have been the story of the game, and even with the big lead, this team continues to be quicker to the ball.
Strong rebounding, and he's rewarded with the easy putback.
Thompson dishes to T. He kicks it to Granger. Olajuwon with a screen on Brown. Granger, he's covered by Brown and stolen by McAdoo. There's the bucket, good.
You know, the instant that steal was made, they were off and running the other way.
Ball pressure, then a run out, Steve. That's perfection to me.
Teague against Arenas. Teague kicks to Granger. That one wide left. Pistons trailed by 20. Here's the three. Good on the shot.
You can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
Boston's gone 6 of 11 when they've taken the three-point shot tonight. Very respectable. Outside T. He passes it to Olajuwon. Both teams deciding to change it up.
Hakeem Olajuwon taking two shots.
And that one falls for Olajuwon.
They're doing a great job here in the second half. They've brought their free throw percentage up quite a bit. And that's winning basketball. That's one of the ingredients in winning basketball. Good free throw shooting.
G's checked in for Boston. Williams comes in for Jeff T. And Olajuwon drops them both.
You know, they've really improved at the line from the first half. Things have gotten a lot better. They've gotten there a good number of times, and they've converted a high percentage of them.
All sorts of time. That's good. Out of bounds. Detroit takes possession.
That's a poor possession. You just give away the ball with a sloppy pass.
If you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Clock at 6, number 45. A second chance effort. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot 2.
Talk about being on his game. Look at the numbers for the Copa. He's got 21 points. A couple of nice steals, too. Not missing much. In fact, hitting just about everything he's taken.
Can he keep this up? Wow.
And he sinks the second. Here's Thompson. Outside Williams. Throws it up high. And it's Thompson with the jam.
What a beautiful pass to set that one up.
The pass might have been pretty, but the finish, I thought, Clark, angry.
That's a heck of a combination. Pretty pass and an angry punch.
I would call it an irate finish, even.
Poked away, and it's out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way.
9 seconds of the shot.
Celtics leading by 18. Outside Williams. The dish to Olajuwon. And it's good. Fought through contact, hits the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
We've seen a noticeable improvement out of him since halftime. He didn't have a whole lot working in the first half.
And that one falls for Olajuwon. Detroit's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Number 45. And Boston with the rebound. Olajuwon's got 6 rebounds now in the game. And Williams, here we go. Excellent D there for McAdoo.
Terrific defense at the rim. They got right in his path.
You know, that's part of what great defenders do. They get not only in your path, but in your head a little bit, too.
And again, it's the Pistons missing.
He's killing them with his poor shooting. The defense is more than willing to give him those shots now.
Outside Williams. Back to Thompson. The shot is off. Some solid defense right there from McAdoo. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Another shot. Thompson with the block. And it's out of bounds to the Pistons as Detroit retains possession. The Pistons making a change here. Mays checked in. Picked by Griffin. Here's McAdoo. Rebound Boston. The biggest lead of the game was 24 points. Goes up on the wing. Thompson with the bucket. Thompson's got 10 points here in the second half.
That jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
Yeah, they've been pulling up and watching them go down.
Pass to McAdoo. Nice ball movement by Detroit. Six to shoot. Shot to stop the drought. And he sinks the layup. McAdoo's got 6 points in the quarter. Time called here. The Celtics decide to top it over. Money's checked in for Detroit.
A fool if I take it all for granted. A smart man if I keep my feet planted to the earth. Cause the people that hurt can understand it. You speaking out of English, I'ma show you how to make it all. Another planet is a short-term goal for me. A record soul for me.
Boston leading by 21. Thompson passes to Williams. Defended by Money. It's Williams with the drive. And there's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
Some really terrific numbers for Williams. He's got 14 points, and all the steals he's collected only add to his impressive stat line.
Yeah, whether he's picking someone's pocket or picking off a pass, he has been causing some mayhem out there for sure.
And Williams drops them both. Detroit's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Money passes to Walker. Shoots from 14, and there's another one for the Pistons.
Well, it's been a tale of two halves, hasn't it, guys? After a terrible first half, he's really picking it up.
Here's G, defended by McAdoo. Thompson outside. Six on the shot clock. Dishes to Granger. There's the triple. Reverses. And Olajuwon finishes inside. Olajuwon's got 11 in the second half.
Not too many of those shots were dropping for him in the first half, but it's been a different story here in the second.
Number 45. He's covered by Thompson. Rebound by Williams.
That's one he knows he should have made.
Leads him in there. Here's G. And the rebound goes to Griffin. Griffin's got 8 rebounds in this game. The pass to Money. Shoots. Can't hit. And the Celtics going the other way now. Here's Williams. With the tip. It's good on the putback.
That's purely a hustle play there. Getting to the offensive glass for the tip in, well done.
And that's, you know, a quality you see any strong offensive rebounder possess. And we saw it right there.
Yeah, it's the anticipation more than anything. It's understanding where that ball is going before anybody else on the floor does.
Fades away. And the rebound goes to Danny Granger. Granger's got his 6th rebound on the night. Thompson, the finger roll finish at the bucket. Thompson's got 6 in the quarter.
Good defense, but gotta love the finish with the finger roll over the top.
And it's Walker penetrating. And that one's good. The Celtics have got a pretty good rhythm going offensively, shooting 8 of 15 for the quarter. Kicks it to Olajuwon. Back to Williams. Feeds to Olajuwon. Griffin's there. Detroit with the rebound. McAdoo's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. Outside, Walker. Pass to Money. Pocket six. There's the screen. He feeds it to Walker. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
Check out the game for Thunder. 10 points and the assist numbers, tremendous.
His court vision, Clark, has been phenomenal. I mean, he could not be passing the ball any better than he is right now.
And so Walker nails both of them. Boston leading by 23. Outside, Williams. Granger up top. Thompson outside. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here. So it's Boston now. G dishes to Elijah Wan. Six to shoot. Takes the 13-footer. Offensive rebound. Second shot opportunity. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. And the first one at the line is good. So he gets them both.
You really have to like their efficiency at the foul line. I mean, they're knocking down 91-92% of their free throws overall. That's a very healthy and positive number.
Number 45 puts the lead pass in front of him. Again, the miss by the Pistons.
And the rebounding numbers don't actually tell the whole story. I mean, they're barely ahead in that category, but when they've needed them, they've gotten them. They've really battled hard.
It's their work on the glass, Steve, that's prevented any kind of momentum swing.
And a new group in for the Celtics. Detroit's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. And it's 7 points for Money.
And I like that move to the hoop. You use your speed, go around the bigger defender.
Pass to Weber. Poked loose. And 101 left to play in the final quarter. Number 25. And that's a foul called on the Beast. That's foul number two for him.
But he tried to step in and cut him off, but just not quick enough.
And we have the benefit of replay, but I think they got that one right, which is the case most times, even though fans don't think so.
54 seconds left in the fourth quarter. The pass to Sampson, defended by McDaniel. Lays it up and banks it in.
You know, with that much of a height advantage, that's exactly what you should do. Take it straight to the rim.
Outside Teague. He dishes it to Weber. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague.
Well, they've done a great job keeping the fans out of the game today. And the closer they get to the win, the quieter it gets.
Yeah, we call that the sweet sounds of silence. They're going to savor this win as well they should. Every road win carries a little extra reward.
Boy, they were ready for him right there. I mean, totally collapsed the defense on him.
Weber kicks the tee. And so it's Boston easily grabbing this one. And